where the future of medicine, technology, and ethics will lead us. There's a major problem facing the medical field today, one that many people might not even be aware of. It's called non-adherence, which is a term used when patients refuse to or are unable to take their medications properly. It can become very difficult for doctors to properly treat their patients if they don't follow their instructions, especially for those involved in outpatient care. It's been estimated that non-compliance to medicine costs around $100 billion a year because patients get sicker and need additional treatments or hospitalization. Medical researchers conducting clinical trials face similar difficulties. Clinical trials can cost millions of dollars and often fail when non-adherence impacts the researcher's ability to assess the effectiveness of the drug. For both cases of outpatient care and clinical drug trials, it's often too expensive or too impractical for doctors and researchers to directly observe medicine intake. What can be done to improve non-adherence rates and allow healthcare professionals to make better informed decisions about patient care? Several medical companies are working to combine the latest technological advancements with medicine to address this issue. An example of one of these companies is called AI Care. They've developed an app that is able to use artificial intelligence to monitor patients taking their medication. The app uses the camera on a smartphone to detect pill placement into the mouth and confirms that it has been ingested. The app can send reminders and instructions if necessary, and also offers providers the ability to monitor adherence in real time. If a dosage is missed, providers are able to get direct contact with their patients via their smartphones. According to one study published on the AI Care website, patients using the app to monitor the intake of the hepatitis C drug Ledispavir resulted in a mean cumulative dose adherence of 93.1% in a challenging patient population, meaning people who reported current or past drug use. AI Care even claims high rates of success in trials with patients suffering from schizophrenia, a chronic brain disorder with serious symptoms. In a 6-month study, subjects using AI Care achieved 89% adherence compared to other schizophrenia trials where average adherence can be as low as 61%. Mental illness like schizophrenia affects millions of Americans. In 2014, it was estimated that nearly 1 in 5 adults suffers from some type of mental illness. For persons struggling with mental illnesses, non-adherence can especially prove to be an issue, as patients are at risk of episodes of instability where they are unable or unwilling to take their medications. Outside of a hospital setting, it becomes difficult to monitor patients and make sure that they are taking their necessary medicines, like antipsychotics and mood stabilizers. Less than a month ago, the FDA announced the approval of the first digital pill called Abilify MySight, which is used to treat people with schizophrenia and bipolar 1 disorder. The drug contains a sensor the size of a grain of sand that is activated by fluids in the stomach. After being ingested, a signal is sent to a patch worn by the user that is then transmitted to an app and logged online, where it can be accessed by others. This allows doctors to easily check up on a patient's medicine intake online and make contact with a caregiver or the patients themselves if they notice missed dosages. Currently, no studies have been done to show that this digital pill improves adherence rates. But technology like digital pills have the potential to take the guesswork out of a physician's job and allows them to make fully informed medical decisions. This could be a huge step forward and someday soon improving care for a variety of illnesses. As advanced as this technology is, for many, monitoring to this degree is a cause for concern. The usage of artificial intelligence and sensors with medication raises questions about patient privacy. In an article published by the New York Times, Dr. Jeffrey Lieberman, chairman of psychiatry at Columbia University, calls the idea of a digital pill a biomedical big brother. Many patients might not approve of their doctor having the ability to keep such a close eye on their medicine intake. Psychiatrist Dr. Peter Kramer agrees and raises the point that the advent of digital drugs could potentially be a coercive tool. Patients might feel pressured into taking medications they don't want to because they feel that their doctor is watching them. People suffering from schizophrenia often have symptoms of paranoia and delusion, which might be exacerbated by a medication that directly monitors them. there are some questions by patients and doctors alike of how accepted a drug like Abilify MiSight will be. Beyond doctors and patients, who could potentially have access to information about medicine intake? One concern centers around the right of legal systems to potentially use this information to determine if persons court-ordered to take medication are being compliant. Court-ordered medication may be used as a condition for persons on parole, probation, outpatient commitment, or those trying to maintain guardianship. Courts may someday impose digital medication as a part of these conditions relating to legal matters. Access to medicine intake information could be a deciding factor in determining someone's freedom. Health insurance companies could possibly offer incentives like copay deductions for people who choose digital medication over regular medication. This again raises concerns about coercion, as patients may feel pressured to choose the more invasive option due to monetary reasons. It's important to note that currently, patients taking the digital medication must sign consent forms with their doctor before they have access to their intake history online. At any time, there is the option to block them if the patient decides. The information does not have to be shared if the patient does not permit it. Therefore, issues of non-adherence are not completely solved by apps like AI Cure or digital medication. Medical technology has the ability to monitor patients. Medical technology that has the ability to monitor patients has great potential to improve care if used properly. In addition to being useful for doctors and researchers, it can be helpful for older patients with memory problems who need help remembering to take their medication. But it also has the potential to cultivate mistrust, especially if patients feel coerced or that their information is being used improperly. We need to address privacy issues that arise with medical monitoring and set what boundaries we can. This type of technology being used today will only continue to develop. We need to prepare for a future when technology can offer great reward, but at the potential cost of becoming more invasive. One such technology that is developing and progressing every day is the field of nanomedicine, which uses nanotechnology for medical purposes. Nanotechnology itself refers to the ability to understand and manipulate materials at incredibly small sizes, materials we can't see with our eyes, like atoms and molecules. The possibilities of nanomedicine are seemingly endless. For example, researchers are working on the development of nanoparticles that would be able to deliver medicine directly to a cancer cell, minimizing the amount of damage done to surrounding healthy tissue. This type of treatment is called cancer nanotherapy. Nanotechnology has the potential to be diagnostic as well as therapeutic, meaning it can be used to detect changes in cells that might become cancerous. This would allow for doctors to become aware of cancer much earlier than with the tools we have available now, allowing more time for treatment. Nanomedicine may one day be used for regenerating damaged parts of the body and restoring them to their normal function. In a 2007 study at Northwestern University, researchers were able to restore function to the hind legs of paralyzed mice by injecting a nanomaterial which stimulated the growth of new spinal tissue. According to the researchers, this study could have huge implications in the future for people with diseases like Alzheimer's and Parkinson's, where there is damage to the nerve cells and brain. In the case of Alzheimer's disease, which affects an estimated 15 million people worldwide, nanotechnology could help in the detection of brain tissue degeneration much earlier than what is possible now. Like cancer, early detection and treatment can help prolong and save lives. There are many more applications of nanotechnology that could be possible in the near future, from building fully functional organs in laboratories to performing surgery at a microscopic level, and so much more. We will have the capability to transform the human body like never before, but amazing developments in technology and medicine open up unprecedented ethical questions. Should nanomedicine be strictly used for medical purposes, or can it be used for bodily enhancements? How will the risk of introducing new technologies into the human body be handled? And how will patient privacy and confidentiality be protected with technology like nanoparticles having direct access to the human body? These are some of the questions that must be addressed before such technologies become widespread. And it's not a matter of if, but when these futuristic scenarios become reality. Although we might not be able to foresee every possible consequence of nanomedicine or other technologically enhanced forms of healthcare, it's up to scientists, policymakers, and the public to have an informed conversation and reach decisions for the future. Technology and medicine combined have a world of possibility ahead of them. It's up to all of us to decide what the